And I live in this apartment. All three of us still sleep in this bed.
My name is Tira, as in tiramisu, the Italian dessert. This is my twin sister, Dhira. This is my mother, Mira.
Our sleeping order first is I'm closest to the wall, and Tira is in the middle, and my mother's on the end. So it doesn't really make sense because I'm the first one out of bed in the morning, so inevitably I wake both of them up when I shut off the alarm clock and I crawl over their bodies because I can't see, so I don't know where their legs are, so I always step on them or, you know, push on them.
Good morning, Mommy.
Good morning, Kira. Oh, my God.
Too small for all of us at one time.
Can you put away some of your clothes?
They don't fit in my drawer.
Doesn't all this have to go to storage?
Oh my God, look what's here, my bra. You know how long I've been looking for this bra?
Dhira, you took the chair and put it in the hallway?
I took the chair and put it in the hallway because there's not enough room for three chairs by the computer.
What
do you need
three chairs? If you're here and you're doing your homework.
It's really uncomfortable because you can't move in there if there's three chairs.
It really hasn't affected my relationship with men. I have two boyfriends.
As long as I see that all three of us are continuing to grow in a spiritual way, then no sacrifice is too much.
Why, Mira, you don't like that?
I thought it was great.
We sort of did.
It's really tough to concentrate and study for exams and things like that when it comes to for schoolwork.
I don't think that there's a fear here of being independent. I think it's an absolute choice that we live together.
Yeah, my apartment's actually right down the street. It's one bedroom, very small, like miniature kitchen that doesn't really, like the door, you open the front door of the house and it hits the sink, and you open the refrigerator and it hits the sink. You open the oven and it hits the counter, and it's awful, you know? It's New York.
I started with two. That's about 8 or 9 years to get to 80. My friends thought as these number of cats accumulated here that I'm completely out of my mind. They don't understand that the whole point now is it's like a hospice for abandoned, abused, unwanted, you know, disabled cats. This is Lang Ho. She has to give me the blessing. She is a sacred cat from Thailand. Not done yet. Mmm, tastes good. I have no social life. It's like just the cats. With my tail in the air. I've yet to meet a woman who can handle all these guys. I don't think I would ever live without this many cats. What do I want to see in my last moments on this planet when I'm reviewing my life? What's going to make me feel better is seeing all these guys' faces, you know, and thinking about, you know, how they got a few more years of life because of my efforts. So that's what really counts. That's what really matters.
The apartment I live in is a three-bedroom, kind of nice, overlooking the water.
I live in New York because the Jews want to live together, because we only eat kosher food and kosher fruit, and we must have a synagogue and all kind of things together.
Christmas is an outlet for me. There's always a reason to make something for Christmas. I made the snowman, or actually a snow woman. I made this little village in here. I papier-mâchéed it up. I painted a cyclorama inside.
I live here in Christmasville. When I bring girls back here, they are absolutely charmed by the Christmas theme. It seems to be a little bit of a draw that, you know, it's Christmas time here. It doesn't hurt.
These are little showgirls, kind of like the little Follies Bergère or Garland Kicker girls. They've got made out of feathers and paper and rhinestones, and I made all of these, every one, the gold one, the red one, the pink one, the green one. And that's part of what I want to do. I want to make Christmas ornaments. This one here is called Times Square. There's a spiral from the top. If you look inside each one, there's little tiny vignettes. There's a little theater inside. There's a little television studio. People that know me well, know that I am basically a workaholic, okay? Some people drink, some people smoke, some people do drugs. What I do is I do art. I can't stop. It's a compulsive obsession I have. And some people will say I'm out there. I don't walk around with a flag saying, I'm strange, look at me, look at me. But I want to come home to my little safe space and be happy.